Hey you guys, welcome back. This is the cast of Camp Riverwood. Today we're going to be doing our Q&A as promised, and we've picked out specific questions for specific cast characters for this Q&A. So without further delay, let's just hop right into it. But first we have a special announcement. From now on, we're going to be doing shoutouts. This idea has been inspired by Awesome Possum Productions, as every time we give someone a shoutout, we will write their name on a piece of paper. You'll see how it all plays out in the end. So stick around and watch the whole video so you'll see who receives a shout-out. LPS Shine TV asks, have you guys ever had braces? Yes, I did. I actually have braces right now.
Nope.
Actually, no.
Yep, I had some way back in the days. Yeah, I actually had some taken off a few months ago.
I actually have braces right now. The next question comes from LPS Paradise, and she asks, are you guys really friends, or is this a reality show? Don't worry, all the series we do are definitely just acting. Yes, every LPS you see in our videos are part of LPS Allison TV, meaning that they're just actors, and none of them are going to be reality shows. Although, that is kind of a good idea. Maybe we could do a reality show in the future. The next question is for me, actually, and it comes from different LPS. Gwen, do you think that Dakota is hot in real life?
You're handsome, but not hot. Sorry, it's a question, okay? I had to give my honest opinion.
None taken. I was kind of hoping you wouldn't think I was hot, because I already have a girlfriend.
And fun fact, guys, she's part of LPS Awesome TV. The next question comes from Pink Diamond LPS. She asks, is there going to be a new character?
Well, you'll have to wait and see.
The next question is also from her. How old are all the actors, IRL, and in the series?
We're all 16 years old in the series, but if you're talking IRL...
I'm 13, but really mature for my age, obviously.
I'm 17, soon to be 18.
I'm 20.
I'm 14.
21. 18.
And 15. The next few questions come from Pet Shop Paradise Productions TM. And she asks, Melody, how would you feel if Gwen never bullied you?
Honestly, then I just think of it as a casual summer camp. And I wouldn't really worry about drama or anything like that.
The next question is also from her, but it's for me this time. She says, other than Camp Riverwood, which series would you like to be in?
Actually, we are really looking forward to producing a new series for you guys. And it is called LPS Sheila Goodwill. It is currently on YouTube, but the first few episodes are a lot different from what it's going to be in the future. We've actually got some notifications from eBay saying that there are new LPS traveling here soon, and they're all willing to take the roles of the characters in the series. I'm actually going to be the mother of the protagonist. Other than that, and Danielle versus Kimberly, I don't really know. I'm kind of in a lot of series, so I'll probably take a break. Next question is, again, from her. Who do you like the most, Melody or Gwen?
IRL, I'm going to keep it a secret, but in the series, I mean, cheating is unacceptable. If this were to happen in real life, I would never want to get back together with Gwen, and I'd try to resolve our conflict between Melody and I instead of break up with her. And if I really were to break up with her, I'd do it in person instead of just leaving her hanging dry, depressed.
So the next question is for Allison.
Every time, man. What is the question this time?
She asks, if you were in this series, which character would you like to be?
Oh, gosh. Man, that is a really hard choice. I'm going to be honest with you guys, and this shouldn't offend you because I'm talking about the characters in the series, not how you guys truly are IRL. You three are all jerks in your ways, and you two kind of influenced Melody badly into doing what she did. And Melody was bad and you're responsible for believing all that crap.
So that leaves you two. You both are really good and supportive friends of Gwen in the series. But I would rather be you, Jocelyn, or Rudy, because, I mean, you actually try to support her. I get that you try to too, Bernie, or Mabel, I should say. But, I mean, you don't do a very good job of it, because you're really naive, you're really dumb in the series, and I guess I'd just like to be Rudy. Obviously, no offense to you. You did a good job in the series.
Thank you, Allison. I will continue to try my best to make you happy.
So, yeah, Rudy's definitely a winner.
Score!
Alright, if there are any more questions, just call me. The next question comes from Molly421 Productions, and she asks, why did you get back together with Gwen if she's such a jerk?
Well, if this were IRL, I definitely wouldn't get back together with her, but Dakota, not me, Bob, but Dakota, well, he's a bit naive.
just because she cheated on me doesn't mean she doesn't love me. Oh, shut up, Dakota. Honestly, I think the role of my character is kind of stupid, yet he's sweet at the same time. That's kind of why I wanted to be him. So, yeah, I wouldn't get back together with her, honestly, in real life, but yeah. This is a drama series. Gotta follow by the script.
Next, from McKinley Clements, I really hope I pronounced that right. For the whole cast, what is your favorite holiday?
Christmas, because if it weren't for Christmas, we wouldn't have gotten a lot of presents. We wouldn't be able to, like, have a special holiday to, like, you know, spend a lot of time with each other and, like, play with our presents with each other. And, you know, it's just such a peaceful, decorative holiday.
Plus, we got a bunch of scrapbook paper like this one for Christmas as well. And we got a credit card to a store nearby so we can get more scrapbook paper and miniature props.
I can see why you like Christmas, but I honestly like, you know, I guess I really like Halloween.
One word, candy. I like the 4th of July. I absolutely love fireworks and they're all so colorful.
I really like Christmas too.
I absolutely love Thanksgiving. I just like food. Plus, it kind of gives us the opportunity to be thankful for what we have in life.
You know, that's really sweet, Jason, but my favorite holiday is Halloween.
You people are crazy. I like my birthday. I consider it a holiday.
Okay, next question comes from GromcatGamer/AlleyCat. She asks if I have any siblings in real life. Actually, I do have a sister. She's currently 26. And, so, yeah, she's pretty cool. She's actually a poet, and she writes really good poems. That's actually where we got the idea of melody-loving poems in the series. But she doesn't actually IRL.
Yeah, I like reading poems, just not writing them.
Kenna Loves Nike asks, everyone, what was your favorite episode in the series?
I kind of liked, 14.
I definitely liked episode 8.
I loved episode 21.
16.
21 as well.
I liked 22.
I just liked 20, period.
Grace really asks, who is your favorite singer, all of you?
Selena Gomez is bae!
I actually really like The Weeknd.
The Weeknd!
Please don't kill me. I like Justin Bieber music.
I like The Weeknd too.
One Direction.
I like Taylor Swift. Arctiquatic asks, Coco, do you like Bob IRL? No, I actually have a boyfriend in real life. So yeah, he's currently in university and belongs to the previous owner I had. I've talked about this in the LPS because of you Q&A. So yeah, he's just in university at the moment and we try to keep in touch. Arctiquatic also asks me if I like Bob IRL.
Well, I may be single, but I just don't like Bob that way, plus he has a girlfriend. Respect that relationship.
Holly Bolly asks all the girls, do you have a boyfriend?
Just answered that.
Nope.
Actually, with relationships, things always go downhill for me, so I prefer to stay a single Pringle.
No, I do not.
I've been a single Pringle all my life, but I like it that way.
Girls are a bit hard to understand. A lot.
Actually, I did recently have a girlfriend, but we broke up a few weeks ago. We just aren't really working out, and we can't really keep in touch very well. I respect that she wanted to break up with me, and honestly, I feel bad if she was heartbroken, but honestly, I'm really fine.
Mainly because we're still friends to this day.
LPS Aquasky TM asks the whole cast, what was your favorite scene?
When I smashed Gwen into the pine tree. I am very sorry, Veronica.
It's fine. I kind of liked when I clawed Melody.
Sorry.
To be quite honest, I really loved when Melody was caught vandalizing.
I liked when we vandalized the cabin.
That was my favorite scene too.
I really like when Gwen was exposed with the viral video. I liked it when Melody and her mom were having a stern lecture about her actions back at Camp Riverwood. I don't know why.
The next one is from the same person, but for me. How did it feel when you broke up with Dakota?
Honestly, it wasn't really emotional for me because, as I said before, I have a boyfriend in real life. I mean, if this answers your question, if we were in a relationship and we broke up, then yeah, I'd be pretty devastated, just like Melody was.
The next question is for me. How much did it hurt when you smashed into that pine tree?
In real life, I probably would have died. But seeing as it's just a show and that tree was simply a prop, it didn't hurt at all. The producers and directors of the show could actually get, like, sued and jailed because,
Well, you're not supposed to actually hurt people with items or props or actual weapons or other really dangerous items. Don't worry, whenever a character gets hurt in a series, it's not like they actually get hurt. They're just acting, the blood is fake, it may be graphic, but it's all fake. That's actually a serious health violation, so like I said before, we could get sued and jailed for that, so we won't want that to happen. LPS9 TV asks a few more questions. For everyone, blonde or brunette, blue, green, or brown eyes?
I like green eyes. I like blue.
Blue.
Green eyes.
Brown eyes.
Blue eyes.
Brown eyes.
And I would have to go with blonde.
Blonde.
Brunette.
Brunette.
Blonde.
Brunette.
Brunette.
We got another question from LPS9 TV, and she asks, on a scale of 1 to 10, how much do you love Oreos?
I'm actually not that big of a chocolate person, despite my name. 7.
I'm lactose, so 0.
10.
10.
10.
10.
8.
The next few questions are asked by White Wolf Gamer.
She asks, Dakota, what were you thinking when you were kissing Veronica and Coco?
Well, seeing as I have a girlfriend, it's a bit spooky for me, but you know, I'm determined to do the best acting, and I guess that's all the information I'm comfortable with giving out.
She also asks, Coco, how does it feel when you had to act like you're crying?
Actually, it's not all that difficult. I had a pretty hard childhood, and I miss my boyfriend, so, you know, I mean, it's pretty easy for me to cry, but, you know, thinking about my boyfriend and the things that made me cry in the first place make me sob even harder, but I guess that's what kind of emphasizes my sadness in the series.
She also asks, Bernie, can you show us your reaction when you knew you had to play as an opposite gender?
Well, both me and Jocelyn actually had to play as opposite gender. We don't really have, like, any reaction clips or anything for you. So, unfortunately, no. But we were really surprised. And we were like, what? No way. But it all pulled together in the end.
She asks me, how does it feel to be taller than the other actors?
Honestly, it doesn't really affect me all that much. It's kind of awkward looking down at other people often, but, you know, it's cool.
She also asks, Monica, were you nervous shooting the first episode?
Well, if you mean second episode, considering that's the first one I was in. Well, actually, no. I actually have a lot of acting experience, and my flaws in the past I have, like, fixed by now, because, honestly, I've just gotten so used to acting, and it's really just my passion. And, yeah, I expected mess-ups, and there were quite a few bloopers, but, you know, whatever.
And she also asks, Jason, what is your favorite food?
Enchiladas.
And finally, the last question comes from Holly Bolly. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we've saved the best for last. She asks, Allison, whose team are you on?
Well, if you must know, I'm on Team Gwen.
Thank you for your question. Alright, everybody, so I'd like to thank you all so much for joining us on our Camp Riverwood Q&A.
Stop making so much racket.
What do you want? I apologize for that interruption. We also apologize if we didn't get to your question. It is probably because we've already gotten to that question before, or we prefer not to answer it.
My cat is playing with my hair right now. Okay, come on, really? 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 Is that the way to act? Is that the way to behave? Huh? Kitty, kitty, kitty?
Anyways, it's time for our shout-outs.
And our shout-out goes out to...
Congratulations, McKinley Clements. You're the first one on our big wall of shout-outs. And don't think I like her more than you guys. I just picked a random comment, picked the first one I saw to feature in this shout-out paper. So just continue commenting on my videos and you will receive a chance for a shout-out. Alright, everyone, see you later.